Halfway through the power play in overtime. Torrey Krug. All the way to Bergeron. Scores! Patrice Bergeron with the silver stick and the golden touch. 5-4 Boston in overtime.
Started by Pastrnak to Marchand and back to Pastrnak, and Grizzly connects with Pastrnak again. Wanted to swagger by, no luck with the follow-up. Bergeron to Pastrnak to Bergeron. He scores! Bergeron, a power play goal!
Good entry again for the Bruins. I mean, they really moved the puck well. Four guys have touched the puck already. The move by Pastrnak doesn't work. A give and go. Far side pass, McElhinney. There's the denial, and the defense gets sort of caught up, and back and forth, Pastrnak to Bergeron.
Final 10 seconds, Marchand to Bergeron, he scores! Patrice Bergeron! And the Bruins have come back to beat Florida in the final seconds! The streak will go to 18!
Sent to the back by DeBrusk, walked over by Krug, and a shot, he scores! A deflection en route! Bergeron has tipped it in, and it is a 1-0 lead for the Bruins.
Krug shoots for the stick, and this puck goes right past the glove of Jordan Binnington.
Seventh power play goal of the playoffs for Bergeron.
And here comes Warren Fogle, using the long strides to get away from Bergeron, but Bergeron wins the puck back, finds Marchand at the attacking line. Marchand shot, scores! Patrice Bergeron, four-time Selke winner, makes the defensive play, sends Marchand in, and Marchand finds the corner.
Potential breakaway, the great effort on the back check.
That's just an unbelievable play.
And what a finish. Marchand picks that puck up at the blue line, wide by the boards, and he's able to get inside the dot and still get that great wrist shot at his left side.
My gosh! What an example of what this big line can do.
And the Bruins dodge a bullet as Patrice Bergeron carries in on the wing to Krejci. Back to Bergeron, scores! Spin around a top corner and the Bruins make it a two-goal game.
Krejci and Bergeron together. A little soft pass in front, and Bergeron somehow able to just sort of chip that up and over the arm of Mike Smith. It was a rolling puck, so that gives you an advantage just trying to sort of hack at it and chip it over.
So it is Slavin with a little over 9.5 to go. A turnover there. Pastrnak dealt it off. Score! Bergeron!
Now this line is going well, and so you don't really need to give him any help.
Boy, what patience by Pastrnak, like you said, for McElhinney. He has no idea Bergeron's there on the back door. He just thinks Pastrnak's going to rip it. He did not, and it gives the Bruins a very comfortable lead now here in this third period.
Now Heinen accelerating out of the corner, cutting off the half boards, low for Bergeron to McAvoy for the tuck. What vision!
Secondary scoring, get your defenseman involved. He takes that nice little cycle pass deep in the offensive zone, keeps his feet moving, gets separation into that high slot. Bergeron gets open for him. And Bergeron knows exactly where he wants to go.
Carlo was on it. He's able to send it ahead to Marchand. 2-on-1. He's got Bergeron with him and only Mantha back. Bergeron drags. Marchand scores! A shorthanded goal to tie it at 2.
As you see, Mantha, the forward, goes down to block that pass. And terrific. A terrific read there by Bergeron to recognize that, get it over, and the finish by Marchand, who just has been fantastic as far as scoring goals all season long. Just a huge shorthanded tally.
Patrice Bergeron becomes the fifth Boston Bruin to reach the millennial mark. All right, here's Marchand taking the tap from Pastrnak, back to Pastrnak. Saved by Leonard, the rebound, Bergeron scores in his 1,000th game.
He hunts the rebound down. He gets to that puck in the blue paint and just forces it in. Get that puck for him.
Guess him a good luck charm.
Barzal tries to saucer pass. Marchand ahead for David Pastrnak. Leaves it off for the 1,000th
season game, man. And Patrice Bergeron has bookend goals. This line, they just love each other. A lot of respect for that man. Days like this seem only to happen in Boston. And Patrice Bergeron with the first and last goals of his 1,000th game.